And I found out at the end of 2005 that I got a new, this is true, got a new son I didn't know I had. Yes, a new son I didn't know I had. And what a great bloody pleasure, trendsetters. At my stage of life, my retirement year, I find out, he did all his research, he found out that I was his father, and I was very lucky to find out that I got a new son. No, that ain't him, Lyrish, you fucking ass. Fucking Irish yelling out, you're weak, your turds float too, Irish. Yeah. I'm fanning him. Found out I got this new son, and he researched it and found out he's a drivy young bloke, been in the army all his life, and he's an expert on military insignia, and he's writing a book about it and that, and he phoned me up and he said, why don't you and Uncle Ishmael come up to Brisbane to the big Militaria exhibition at the showgrounds there? And I went up there, and if you ever get a chance to go to one of those military exhibitions, you walk around there, there's all these fuck-asses walking around, fair dinkum they are, baldy-headed blokes with big boots, and they think they're bloody Hitler youths. And they're fair dinkum. Oh yeah, I'm a fucking Hitler youth, I'm gonna buy a dagger, I'm fucking just a cat's ass. I'm a Hitler youth, yeah. And that's true, and I'm walking around, and here's a bloke coming towards me about bloody 50 yards away up this bloody big hall, and he's dressed in a complete Luftwaffe suit. And he looked like fucking Colonel Klink. And he's fat income. Imagine wearing a Luftwaffe suit round town, what a fuck ass. And he's walking on, and I went up to him and I said, mate, I said, schlafen, fumfen, stinken, arsch, and fumfen, schlumpf. Stinfin, finfin, stinkin' arsh and fumfin. There's that albino bloke with the no arse head. I said, arsh and lick and fumfin, schlav and fumfin, schlumpf. I said, and I look around, and here's me Uncle Ishmael looking at the Japanese swords. And he looks at me and he goes, I've always wanted a Japanese sword. He said, there's one here. It's 350 year old, $750. He said, I'm not allowed to own weapons, hold weapons, he said, but I'm going to buy it and keep it at your house. And he's about to buy it, and this little Japanese businessman comes running up, nice suit with a briefcase and everything, but he comes running up, he looks at my Uncle Ishmael and he goes, you cannot have that sword. That is a mess hall. You cannot have that sword. I have deposit on that sword. That is my ancestral sword. That is sword be my family. That is my sword. You cannot have that sword. Uncle Ish turned around. He said, what the fuck are you talking about, mate? Little Japanese bloke, he goes, oh, he said that is my sword. My ancestor will make that sword on anvil ping pong ping. On anvil. That is my sword. You cannot have that sword. I have deposit on that sword. I must take that sword back to Japan. Because that is a mice hole. I must take that hole. And Uncle East turns around and he goes, fuck off, you Jap cunt. He goes, that's what he said. And this little Japanese bloke got really angry. Bangs his briefcase down and he goes, Australian man think of very smart. You think you win the war, but you did not win the war. Japan man will buy Australia, we will win the war and the war. You did not win the war. That is my soul. You did not win the war. You must give me that soul. That is my ancestral soul. You cannot have that soul or spread a mind. And then he says, and then he keeps going, he goes, I must take that soul back to our Japan. My wife will meet me out of door to wear a night kimono. She will meet me a fish, wear a sock. She will meet me a
warfare will fight a nori roll. Nori roll. So a meme or a raw shetway or siwi, I will eat fine or right with siwi. And my wife, she will make me someone man or more. She make an armor, I'll place my on my shoulder, tie a hubcap on my cock, I will have a stainless steel tray on my asshole. She will make me armor for my soul, man, my soul, because you are a Australia cop. You are big cop. You are a sweater man, big cop, cops are a cop. And you are a sweater man, you'll get hot. Get hot. A sweater man, get hot. You are a sweater man, cop, cop. You are cop. A sweater man, cop.
East turns around, he said, mate, he said, in Australia when two blokes are arguing over something, they settle it with an ass-kicking contest. The bloke who can take the worst ass-kicking wins. I'll go first, fucking spin around. Uncle Ish has got his cowboy boots with a Mexican silver toes, and he laid an ass-kicking on this little fuck-ass you wouldn't believe. You'd think Uncle Ish was in the bloody World Cup. He kicked the shit out of this little fuck-ass. Japan man is leaning on the metal cabinet like that. His suit's all crumpled. He's going, oh, that a bad ass kick. You'll get me a very bad, bad ass kick. Oh, you'll kick my asshole in the core of my asshole. That center core of my asshole. You'll bruise my pie. Bruise my pie, your cunt. You have kicked my... It's now my turn. It is my turn. And Uncle Lee said, mate, if you want the sword that bad, fucking take it. Heheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheheh